I'm JC Cleveland.
I'm JC Schutz.
And I'm Kate Owenson.
And today is Thursday, May 23rd. Hey JC, what's for lunch today?
For the lunches, jumbo corn dogs with steamed carrots and peaches.
Yum!
Mm-hmm.
Hey Kate, what's the joke?
The joke is, what did one plate say to the other plate?
What?
Dinner's on me. Hey JC, what's the quote?
The quote is, life is 10% what happens to us and 90% how we react to it.
Wow.
Hey JC, what's the NBI topic of the day?
The NBI topic is the power of positive energy. For an example is, if you smile or even give someone a high five, it will affect them and others in a positive way.
High five.
Hey Cade, what's the word of the day?
The word of the day is focus. To concentrate on something is focus. Hey JC, what's the anti-bullying?
The anti-bullying is, if you dream big and work hard, you will be given more opportunities to pursue those dreams. Hey JC, what are the birthdays today?
Happy birthday to nobody.
Happy birthday.
Hey Cade, what's the fun fact of the day?
The fun fact is, did you know that there are more public libraries than McDonald's in the U.S.?
Wow.
Interesting.
Wow.
Guess what?
What?
There are 6 days for sixth grade and 12 days for everybody else. Hey guys, what are the announcements today?
Today is Blacktail Cleanup for 6th and 4th.
Tomorrow is WCC for 3rd grade and 4th grade, and Epic Mental Health Walk.
Howdy, Rathcats. I'm Katie Ellingson, and I'm here with...
Sydney Whitaker.
And I'm going to be talking about East. Are you nervous about going to East?
Kind of, but I'm also really excited.
What are you afraid of?
I'm afraid of getting lost.
What are you looking forward to?
I'm looking forward to seeing all my friends from other schools.
What advice would you give younger Wildcats?
Just to be respectful, responsible, and productive.
Thank you.
Wildcats, I'm Cole Domi, and today I'm here with
Connor Seymour.
And we're going to talk to him about East. So, are you nervous about going to East?
Yes.
What are you afraid of?
Just going to a new school.
What are you looking forward to?
Just getting to make new friends.
What advice would you give younger Wildcats?
Just turn in your work on time and don't be mean to your teachers.
Okay, thank you.
Hello Woody Wildcats.
I'm Malcolm Moore.
And I'm Dylan Powers.
And we're the Wildcat Wizards.
Today is National Lucky Penny Day. National Lucky Penny Day is observed each year on May 23rd. See a penny, pick it up, all day long you'll have good luck.
When you are out and about, look on the ground for pennies. It just might be your lucky day. From the National Daily Calendar. Bye, Woody Wildcats. Hope you have a great day. See you again tomorrow. Peace!
Wildcats, I'm Keegan Hunt, and I'm the weather. The high today is 46, the low is 33, and there's a 60% chance of precipitation. Bye.
Hello, Wildcats. I'm Avery Walker, and I'm here with
Mrs. Kennis.
And I'm going to ask her some questions. Are you proud to be a CEO, and why?
I am proud to be a CEO. I'm proud to be a CEO because being a CEO means that you're being a leader and that you're being a good role model to others. You can make a difference being a CEO by being a chief energy officer and spreading your energy, which is hopefully positive, to other people. A CEO represents being a leader and, like I said, a chief energy officer. So when we talk about the energy bus, we refer to a CEO as being a leader or being a Wildcat role model.
Improved your energy.
Well, this year I've been, well, since the beginning of the year, my New Year's resolution of improving my energy was to focus on making myself healthier and better so that I feel good about myself so I can help others feel good about themselves.
Your energy affects others and why?
Most definitely, I think your energy affects other people. I think if you have a positive attitude, you can spread that positive attitude. Unfortunately, if you have a negative attitude, you can spread that too. So always try to smile and be the reason why someone else smiles.
CEO outside of school.
Well, I think being a CEO outside of school kind of goes with raising my own family. I try to be a leader in our family and try to be positive, and I try to help my girls see the positive in everything instead of just focusing on negatives. Being another CEO is with your friends outside of school. Even though they might not be a Whittier Wildcat, you still can be a person who has an that makes an influence on them and be a positive, happy person.
What does this mean to you?
Being kind is something that is so easy to do, and it doesn't have to be something. It can just be saying hello, or it can be a smile, and it can make a difference in somebody's day. Also giving a compliment if you see someone doing a nice thing for somebody else, or you like their hair, or if you like their sweatshirt, just saying that you like those things can be being kind to somebody. It doesn't have to be a materialistic thing to be kind. Writing a card can be kind to other people. Giving a compliment, even a sticker on a paper, could be something kind.
What does it mean to you?
Filling buckets to me means that you are trying to, everybody needs somebody to focus on the positive, and sometimes it's hard for you to see that. Sometimes in your own classroom you might feel like you're just going through the motions, but like today Mrs. Hunter brought me a coffee, and that filled my bucket because I was happy to get a coffee on this nice snowy cold day in that's supposed to be spring, and it made my whole day. So filling buckets can be, again, a compliment, or it can also be something like a coffee, or it can be a card, or it can be a picture, or it can be a smile.
Say to the audience.
I just want to thank all the Wildcats for having another fantastic school year here at Whittier. I think we keep getting stronger as a staff, and our students are being productive, kind, responsible, and respectful, and keep up the good work. And thank you for always supporting the broadcast.
Thank you. Have a great day.
Hello, Whittier Wildcats. I'm Aubrey, and I'm here with Peyton Pierce. And we're going to ask her a few questions. So what has been your favorite part of the school year so far?
Math.
What is your favorite part about being in fourth grade?
The teachers.
If you could go back in time or to the beginning of the school year, what advice would you give yourself that make fourth grade here at Whittier even better?
To work harder.
What is your favorite candy?
Chocolate.
What is your favorite subject at school?
P.E.
What is something positive you want to do from now until the end of the school year?
Be kind.
Okay, thank you.
Hello, Whittier Wildcats. I'm Cassie Casagrande, and I'm here with
Kaylee Swoboda.
And we're going to ask her a few questions. What has been your favorite part of the school year so far?
Being nice to others.
What is your favorite part about being in third grade?
The teachers.
What advice would you give yourself to make third grade here at Whittier even better?
Helping others.
What is your favorite candy?
An Airhead.
What is your favorite subject at school?
Reading.
What is something positive you want to do from now on until the end of the school year?
Be nice to others.
Thank you. Hello, Whittier Wildcats. I'm Cassie Casagrande, and I'm here with
Jamie Knott.
And we're going to ask her a few questions. What is your job here at Whittier?
I work in the CSCT program, and I am a therapist.
What have we learned about mental health from all the special guests on broadcast?
So over the last several weeks, we've had several guests. We've had Mrs. Jonart yesterday, who talked about stress. We've had Ms. Schulte, who's talked about physical exercise and how that helps us feel better. We've had Nurse Jenny, Ms. Weigel. She talked about school counseling. We've had Ms. Schwemmen, who's talked about art therapy and how art can help us with our own mental health. And so if you look right here, we do have a wall. And so this is the art therapy kind of wall that other students have done.
Who can I talk to at home if I'm feeling overwhelmed?
So definitely your parents. You can talk to grandparents, aunts, uncles, whoever you feel close to. The important thing is that if you are feeling overwhelmed or stressed or depressed and it doesn't seem to be going away, talking to an adult.
Who can I talk to at school if I'm overwhelmed?
You can talk to Miss Weigel. You can talk to Mr. Shod. You can talk to your teacher. You can talk to CSCT. You can talk to Lori in the lunchroom. Anyone you feel like you have a strong connection with that you feel like you can trust, you can talk with them. But if you feel like you're not feeling better after talking, sometimes we do have to talk with someone else, like a therapist in the community, or maybe it's even a conversation to have with your doctor.
What is coming up this week with mental health awareness?
So we have the EPIC Mental Health Awareness Walk on Friday, and students will go to the gym first. You will get lined up, and then you will walk around the school. Out here on the playground by the kind of by the field, we'll have the word EPIC in the fence, and every student will get a green ribbon, and you will tie your green ribbon around the word EPIC. And the green represents mental health awareness. That's the color. So we're encouraging every student to wear their Whittier shirts or any green shirt.
Anything else you want to say to the audience?
The one other thing that I do want to say is that if a friend talks to you about feeling overwhelmed or stressed, it's really important that you talk to an adult about how they're feeling so that we can help them get the help that they need.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Fantastic day! Round.